after World War II, the world believed that it was at peace. But it was wrong. After World War II, communist Russia and capitalist United States participated in a series of proxy wars all throughout the 1950s, 60s, 70s, and even to this day. The Korean War was the best example. North Korea was annexed, funded, and supported by Russia, whereas it became a communist regime, whereas South Korea was annexed, supported financially, and propped up by capitalist United States. The war ended in a stalemate, and for years, North Korea was actually more prosperous. The people worked together, and it was a communist paradise. But just like what happens in all forms of government, someone gets greedy and someone wants all the power for themselves, and that's exactly what happened. 95% of the population became poor and starving, whereas the leaders had plenty for themselves. In South Korea, capitalism took over. It was a slow process, but they had development technologically, economically, and so forth. The people had individual choice, what kind of clothes they wanted to purchase, where they wanted to work. Things seemed to be great. But suicide rates continue to rise. Resources are limited because it's a small peninsula, and the economy is constantly going up and down, just like in any other capitalist society. But for the most part, South Korea is relatively a wealthy nation. The same experiment was tried again in Vietnam. The Northern Alliance was supported by the communist Russians, whereas the southern portion of Vietnam was supported by the capitalist Americans, who also funded and supported the Khmer Rouge, who turned as a rogue ally, and they killed millions of their own Cambodian brothers and sisters. After these various Cold Wars, it appears that capitalism has ranked supreme, whereas the United States has over 900 bases in 130 different countries, whereas only a handful of nations still attempt to practice communism and socialism. But all of these systems are flawed. Communism bred an environment where someone would rise up and become a leader and hoard all of the power for themselves. The same thing is happening in capitalist society. Even though capitalism gives us individual choice as to where we want to work and how we want to spend our money, it is still widely exploitative. 90% of people in America are wage slaves, whereas only 10% are successful business owners. In capitalism, abundance is required to function. Whereas in socialism and communism, it is said that they only use exactly what they need to survive and function on a sustainable level. That's the theory, anyways. But in capitalism, it is admitted that abundance is needed. We need lithium for cell phones. We need cotton. We need wood and oil. That abundance is needed. We need lithium for cell phones. We need cotton. We need wood and oil. If our lands run out of these things, then we must invade other countries. Lockheed Martin, Raytheon, these are private companies, and they profit very much from these wars. The same thing in communism and socialism. When they run out of resources, they must invade other countries. In order to survive in a capitalist nation, you must create a product, and you must become a narcissist. Look at me, subscribe, buy my product. Look at me, I'm the best. And we become a nihilist society. The more socially liberal that we become, we stop believing in God. We stop believing in marriage. And we started to adopt this policy that the community does not matter. The individual, we are all that matters. We are alone. We are the most loneliest society in the United States, in the world, the Americans? The answer isn't communism or capitalism, it's spirituality.